Good evening, everybody, and thank you, Nashua City, New Hampshire. What a wonderful welcome. Honestly, I did not even know that I would be called on stage and asked to also speak. So I wasn't really prepared to speak to an audience like this. But as I was sitting there, I was kind of reflecting. It's been 15 years with Pawan Kalyan. I started my journey with him when he stepped out to direct the film Johnny. And what a 15 years it has been. On one side, I could have an amazing journey in the film industry. On the other side, when a more enriching journey with a wonderful human being. It all started with Johnny, I remember. I should tell the dignitaries on the dais and the audience here, and most of the audience know, it was Kalyan's first venture out into direction also. He did put a great effort. We all worked as a team, but the film did not do well. It didn't take off. They don't want to hear even that. They wouldn't accept it. But what I remember was at the end of the film, he wouldn't take a single rupee of remuneration through the making of the film. But at the end of the film, I was to go and give him his remuneration, which was probably $500,000. And he just pushed it back and he said, give it back to the people who invested on my film and I wouldn't take it. This actually left a very lasting impression on my mind, because I've heard, and we all hear a lot of people say that they are not really tempted by money, but to witness something like that, I think that left a lasting impression. A few years later, I remember we went for a film premiere, we got off the car, and there was a deafening response. The crowd went berserk, everybody was cheering him, and I said, Kalyan, you rock, you're a star, man, you rock. He said, they're cheering for that image they see on the screen, and if I ever get carried away, the magic will be gone. I mean, that was another instance when I remember very clearly that he always has his feet on the ground. And then I have other amazing experiences, like we did a film, Gopala Gopala, where he agreed to do a guest role which just required 20 days of his time, and he played Lord Krishna. And I remember the day when the most important scene of the film, when they call it the Vishwarupam, that scene was to be filmed, where the lead actor of the film realizes that this person in front of him is actually Lord Krishna. And we had 160 people on the sets and everything was set. Kalyan got off the van, he walked up to the set and he said, I'm not shooting today, and he walked off. Venkatesh Garu, the other star, just hugged him and said, no, when he's not in his mood, let's not even... He just turned around and told me, Sharad, I'm not going to shoot today because I'm not God. I don't feel like God. I said... As a producer, I did my best to convince him to stay back because everybody was there. The entire crew, the director, and he says, no, I'm not God. I said, we know you're not God, but can we act? Can we do it? He said, you don't understand. Let's call it off. And he asked me to jump into his vehicle. We drove off. We went off to his farmhouse. In half an hour, we were there. He got me a hot cup of coffee. I still couldn't recover the fact that we suddenly called off shoot. And then he explained to me that when you don't have any turbulence in your mind, when you're calm and when you're serene and when you're probably not even having a disturbed stomach, to everything, your mind, body, and soul is aligned, then you are, or any one of us, is God. And he says, today I'm not God. So, and the next day, he was there at the shoot, and I think he delivered one of his finest performances, and the film speaks for that. And so now, here I stand, and this is yet another experience for me in my journey with him. Yeah. He's been our Gopala Gopala. He's been our Sardar Gabbar Singh. And he's now our Katam Raidu.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.